All right, now, Lisa, as everyone looks around here and they see this well-manicured lawn in the back, who helps you with this?
Primarily my son, Joey, but we have just a crew of people that really work at keeping this as beautiful as it is.
Now, most of the plants original, trees, shrubs, anything that...
Actually, of the 11 oak trees, thus the name Leven Oaks, it's 11 without the E, we have some of the original oak trees still here. There's actually 5 on the property right now.
So that was really the history behind the name.
Absolutely. In some of the old literature, you'll see the word hyphenated. Some of them, you'll actually see it spelled out 11 Oaks, and some Leven Oaks. So we opted, even though we changed the dynamics of the business, we opted to keep the historic name.
All right, I'm looking at this patio.
Mm-hmm.
All right, is that part of the original structure?
Oh, actually, I'm glad you asked. That was all added on. That was added on by me in about 10 years ago. I didn't like that the residents that are housed in this other annex couldn't get directly into the dining room. So I added the entire porch with the steps and the entrance so that they can go directly from their units into the dining room, and the residents in the dining room could come outside without too much of a problem.
But at the same time, keeping that historical connection.
Absolutely. Even though we were never able to restore it back to what it looked like in 1911. Everything we do here has the essence, if you will, of 1911. I mean, in 1911, the rooms did not have bathrooms. So to put it back to the way it was would not work today.
All right, I find myself nestled up under a whole lot of shade.
This is our side yard. And if you can see behind me, that kind of bright green building is actually the back of the storefronts that face Myrtle Avenue. That we have what's called a zero property clearance, so that those buildings were built during the Depression. They were built so that we could bring in revenue, or they could bring in revenue to the Leven Oaks. So you had the Leven Oaks liquor store, the Leven Oaks tack shop. I understand there was even a bakery.
So it's almost a little business center within itself.
It was, because obviously during the Depression, people were not vacationing, so the income coming into the Leven Oaks was not what they needed. So they added all of this on so that they can bring more revenue.
All right, now I'm looking around and I see a majestic oak tree.
And that's one of the original 11 oak trees. There's actually 2 of the original, and this would have been the original side yard of the Leven Oaks. These trees would have faced and still do face Myrtle Avenue. And we have another tree here that's, so right there you see 3 of the original 11. These have sprouted out afterwards. They're not the original.
Okay. All right, the little birdhouses, any history behind those?
Absolutely none. Because under an oak tree, you can't really grow anything. Yeah. So my residents come out here, they sit, they talk, and I wanted something with some kind of decor, so I added the birdhouses just for it to be cute.
There are many birds come by?
Lots of them.
Okay.
They really do.
Any snowbirds?
Only in the snow months. And if you'll notice, again, when I bought the Leven Oaks in 1984, all of the bathrooms that existed had clawfoot tubs.
Oh, we're looking right at them.
Absolutely.
Hello there. How you doing today, sir?
I've seen you before.
Oh, you see. Is that good or bad?
Bad.
What is your name, sir?
Walter Bauer, B-A-U-E-R.
How long you been here, Walter?
4 years, September 1st.
All right. Can I ask you your age out of curiosity?
27. You tell me.
Not a bit over 55.
Thank you.
And his son?
86.
86? What's the secret to keeping those wheels turning?
Well, I can't tell you that.
All right. One of those guys now. Okay.
That's a secret.
Okay. You're just chilling, I take it. Having a cup of coffee?
Yeah, waiting for time.
Okay. You know. Time is still moving, right?
Hope so, yeah.
Walter, do you want to share who your son is? Because a lot of our viewers have met him.
Brian Bauer. He was a bailman in Monrovia for 40 years.
Wow.
He just retired.
Yeah.
Just retired now.
Yeah. He's the mailman with the long hair.
Long hair.
All right, is that DNA is real good, huh?
Yeah. Sure. But let's see, I've been in business here at Monrovia too. I had an automobile shop.
Okay.
I was a mechanic.
Now, what do you really like staying about here? What is it that makes you say, hey, I like this?
right there.
Oh, all right. Enough said.
Good one, Walter. I'll give you the $5 later.
All right, makes sense. Thank you so much now, too. Enjoy yourself. All right, as we move right along, it'll be perfect for Amira, my granddaughter.
That's exactly why. This area is our family dining area, because a lot of the residents will have family that come over and visit. And although people don't have assigned seating, they usually sit in the same place. So if families come to visit them, there's not enough room at their table, so they're able to sit here. And if they have grandchildren or great-grandchildren, we wanted someplace for them to
They got to love it.
That's right. And that's why we did a half wall. Because although a resident might want privacy, they want to be seen.
All right, wanting to be seen. Let's move along, okay? All right, I've seen somebody up on the ladder.
I think
he might need an intro. This may be who now?
This is my son. This is my son, Joey Naylor. And Joey has been here since you were how old? 4.5, 5 years old. He does most of the maintenance here. this has been his whole life.
Joey, I'm going to shift it real fast.
Oh, boy.
All right. What keeps you here?
Her. the love of this place, I guess. I don't know. I wouldn't be the same without it. It'd be weird.
What do you learn from being around so many senior citizens plus?
Well, I learned the secret to life.
And what is that secret? Share it with us.
Never get married. I was told that by a 110-year-old.
Never get married. Now, there's some woman out there who was probably watching and saying, this is a nice-looking guy, and then you just hit it with that.
I'm just telling you, the gentleman was 110 years old who told me that. So you have to take that into consideration.
All right. So you got off the hook real fast with that. What else have you learned?
I've learned everything. It's hard to break down the specifics that I've learned here. Everything I know I learned from here.
All right. So what is like a typical day for you?
Days are never typical around here.
There's
never a typical day. As you can see here, we've got 4 sets of lights that are out that I'm trying to work on. A couple weeks ago, I etched the glass on these doors.
You did that?
I did.
Oh, okay. So you're a terrific handyman.
I consider myself a jack of all trades.
Okay.
Master of none.
All right, but you seem to be doing pretty well.
It's all I know.
So if someone was out there wondering, what's the biggest joy that you get out of your job, what would you tell them?
The fact that I get as many tools as I can possibly use.
Oh, you're a tool man.
I love tools.
It's like a toy box.
Right. And I get to be around my mom all day.
All right, let you get back up putting the lights on since you don't want to get married.
Okay. Thank you very much.
All right, thank you. All right, let's head.
Heard him say that the best part was being around his mom, and that's on film, right?
Yeah.
So I can get that. Okay, thank you.
Right.
let me point, enough of that nonsense. Let me point out. Now, originally, as I say, all of these beams and all of the wood looked as it is today.
Right.
But in 1984, it was all painted white. So I was lucky when I was stripping this particular piece of wood, the paint had not adhered to it.
Okay.
So it came out on one piece. Now, what it says is, in Gaelic, gin your heart be called, I cannot warm thee. If your heart is cold, I cannot warm you. And that is so much the essence of the business that we run today. We can help people as much as they will allow us, but if they're cold-hearted,
it's not going to happen.
Nothing we can do.
Everybody can just sit by the fireplace and warm up.
And get
up.
Warmed up.
Okay, tell me about the clock that's over there.
Actually, all of these clocks were gifted to Leven Oaks from residents and their families. None of them are the original clocks that existed in here. Actually, none of the furniture is original to the hotel. All of it has been brought in by me and the families of the residents that lived here. The only exception to that is those lights that Joey was working on.
Yes.
They're 5 lights. They're original to the hotel. As we talked about outside, Louis Vollmer was an ornamental iron manufacturer.
Yes.
He also manufactured these lights. They're solid brass. They were piped in with gas so that they were lanterns when the hotel was built, and they've been converted over to electrical. I had them stripped. They were all painted white as well. And as I said, they're solid brass. Each light has hundreds of little pieces. But now they are the only original pieces left in the hotel.
All right, can't get past this here. Tell me something about this here.
This organ, which is a pump organ, I bought this sight unseen out of someone's garage for, I think it was $300.
You're kidding.
No, they called me and said, I have a pump organ, and are you interested? And either you want it or you don't. And I thought, okay, I'm going to take a chance. I'm going to take a chance and in the condition that it's in.
Amazing.
Monrovians have been more than generous to this building.
So in many ways, this is a living museum.
It is. It really is. And I lied a minute ago when I said the only thing original to the hotel is those lights. Around the corner here is the original safe.
Where is the original safe?
Right here.
Does anyone know the combination?
I did.
Are you serious?
Yes. And on here, if you look real closely, it's etched the Leven Oaks. And that was original. That was housed in the cage that people made their payments. And as they paid, the money went into the safe.
Is there any money in there now?
Not a dime.
How do you know that?
I opened it.
No. Then you forgot the combination?
There was nothing in it. I didn't need to remember.
Old rock or new rock? Tell me about this.
New rock. Got it down at the street fair on Friday nights many years ago.
Okay. All right. Now this is...
Again, one of the many things, I mean, one of the blessings aside from the business that I'm in is that, you know, yes, I get to take care of wonderful people, but I also get to go to yard sales and estate sales, and these are all things that I've picked up over the years.
Why a Ferris wheel?
Because we're all young at heart. And so the residents really seem to like that. It makes everyone smile.
Childhood memory.
Absolutely, as the doll in the buggy. Yeah. And I try and get pieces that people can talk about. Okay. And give me stories of how it relates to them.
All right. Moving right along, as they say. Man, look at the size of this tree.
One of our original oak trees. This is actually the other side of the Leven Oaks. We saw the side with the gazebo that faced Leven Oaks. This are the other stores on the other side of the entryway. And one of the original 11 oak trees.
So how old is this tree?
It's at least 100 years old. It was here originally to the hotel, and behind you would be Myrtle Avenue. So those stores are all part of the change, if you will. That
all right, wait a minute. Hold everything. This tree is 100 years old.
Easily.
Let's get a little closer. All right, in the background, I have a tree that's 100 plus.
It is. It's one of the original 11 oak trees. And this would have been the front yard of the 11 oaks, or the side yard.
Oh, we'd be looking out at...
Myrtle Avenue. So this chair would be facing the other way, and people would be sitting under the old oak tree looking at people as they walked on Myrtle Avenue.
Flashback in time.
I know, huh? I know. And this, again, on this side of the building, we have zero clearance, so the building starts right there. My property starts when theirs, or mine ends, theirs starts. And so it was just boring. So one day I got some of my girlfriends out here, and we painted... The continuation of the secret garden.
All right, I'm loving it. I'm looking at the shade of this tree.
It's beautiful.
Do they get special care? They're special trees.
They do. All the oak trees do. We only prune them in the summer months because on an oak tree, you don't want it to cut where the rain could get in and destroy the tree. So in June and July, in the beginning of August, we prune it back every year.
All right, who is that lady that made a poem? I think I'll never see a poem as lovely as a tree. Way back in the days. I remember that. Unbelievable. And I look at this. No singing, trust me. But I'm looking at this tree and if it could talk and the stories that it could share.
And look at all the knots and turns in it. I mean, to me, sitting under this tree as well as the other oak tree, there's just so much history here.
Yeah.
And you're right. If the tree could talk, can you imagine?
Right. And a reflection of life. What is knots and its turns, but forever living.
Nice. Yeah. You're good. You're good. Come on, let's go.
All right, let's go. It's getting a little bit too... All right.
Okay, see where it jettisons out?
It protrudes out.
Uh-huh.
Like something was added.
And it was. And if you look at the corner here where the windows are, you can see how it kind of cuts into the window jam. It's because this, there's two bathrooms that were added. And if we continue going, there's more protrusions, but they're not all logical.
Okay. Loving the tree. Loving the tree.
This was originally here, this wall. Okay. And when I came here, this was all covered over. So the dirt came up to this wall.
Okay.
And so little by little, as I was digging it out to kind of clean this area out, I unearthed this wall and this sidewalk. So that's why you have the secret garden.
And the rocks and the stones probably came from up from the hills.
Of course, the river rock. You're absolutely correct. Beautiful, huh?
Yeah, tell me about the little birdhouse over there. Any history for that birdhouse?
No, that one's just a birdhouse that's here. And, you know, we were on the Mother's Day, the Old House Preservation Group. We were on the tour. And there were so many people that came back here and went throughout the building and were surprised by, as you kind of are today, about what's here. So if anyone that's watching the show that wants to come and have a tour, just call us here.
Oh, really? You give tours?
We do. We do. And, you know, we love to give them in groups so that we're not doing that all day long. But anytime during the week that someone wants a tour, and I'm usually here every day.
So you share the history.
I do. And I'm proud of it. I'm proud to share the history, I should say.
That's beautiful.
Yeah.
That also keeps the spirit of the people alive in more ways than one.
Is that a segue to the next show?
I keep going back to the basement. And your name is?
My name is Rosalie Norris, and I've been here almost 6 years.
6 years, and you've been enjoying it, I take it?
Yes, and next month I'll be 92 years old. How about that?
92? What's the secret to your success?
Thank you very much.
What's your secret? What's the secret to 92?
Well,
some of those young people out there.
Having a lot of friends. I have a lot of friends.
Oh, that's beautiful.
I do. I've every place I've ever been, I've seemed to have been really lucky and have a lot of friends. And I told Lisa a long time ago, one of these days I'm going to come see you. And she said, well, welcome you. I said, here I am now.
Oh, that's beautiful. That's beautiful.
It's my home away from home.
All right, sounds good to me. We're going to guarantee you on camera.
Well,
then we're going to get you a copy of this show, okay?
Well, I'll tell you, I don't look very well on camera. Sorry.
You look good to me.
Thank you. Thank
All
you.
Right. Take care of yourself, and thank you for your
okay.
time.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
And who's this guy sitting next to you?
Well, you've already seen him, I think. That's my buddy, Walt.
Enough said.
Yeah. We're buddies.
Exploring a historical place is always fun. But there's a sad part when you have to say goodbye. So I'm going to look for my friend Walt Shelley that extended an invitation for me, Travis, and Lisa to give us a tour through here. Come on. One last word with Walt.
Listen,
I want to thank you so much for extending the invitation.
Oh, you're more than welcome. In fact, you better come back and join us again because we like what you've done today and we want more shows from here.
All right, more shows here from 11
Oaks. We got history. That's history in there.
And it's living history.
That's right. That's right. They've gone through a lot of the Depression, a lot of us, World War II. A lot of things, and the story is still there. You just have to bring it out.
I just have and to bring it out.
And who brings it out better than Ralph? Well,
I'm so honored by that, yeah. Walt. But the next time I come, I want you to make sure that you come down in the basement with me. They say that was a story within itself.
Yeah, they do. They got a lot of stuff down there.
Have you discovered anything yet?
I've been afraid to go down there because I don't know if I'd come back out or not.
Yeah. To all the viewers out there, what would you like to say to them?
Say goodbye, but open arms to come in and join us.
Thank you so much, in a thousand ways.